Freedom is like oxygen. When you're breathing it, you're not even conscious of it. In South Africa, I knew that something was wrong. I knew that I didn't like the way black people were treated. I think the thing that really changed me was coming to the United States, which I did first as a high school exchange student. And then when I returned to South Africa, I became very active in anti-apartheid activities. It's not only that you see how degraded they are being treated, it's how long your own life is, that you have all of these privileges, that you have access to all of that, and yet they have access to nothing.
This is a day of affirmation, a celebration of liberty. We stand here in the name of freedom. Today, I'm glad to meet with the National Union of South African Students. Here in this very audience are hundreds and thousands of men and women who could transform the lives of millions.
To have this man stand up and speak to us about the fundamental human values that I believed in by then made an enormous impact on me.
First is the danger of futility. The belief there is nothing one man or one woman can do against the enormous array of the world's ills, against misery, against ignorance or injustice.
She has been a pioneer in bringing down apartheid in South Africa and a pioneer in helping recognize the rights of gays and lesbians in the United States. How many people, whether they're lawyers, right, or non-lawyers, have had that impact? There have been presidents of the United States who haven't had that kind of impact.
The second danger is that of expediency, of those who say that hopes and beliefs must bend before immediate necessities, that there is no basic inconsistency between ideals and realistic possibilities.
In the Massachusetts decision, it wasn't so much about gay and lesbian couples. It really had more to do with what is this country founded on? You know, freedom and liberty and equality and those types of things that are really valued by everybody. And if those are true for everybody, it has to be true for us too. Framing in that context set the stage for the way the Supreme Court looked at that.
Defense of Marriage Act, which for federal law, defined marriage as the union of one man, one woman, only denied all federal benefits to gay couples, that has been ruled unconstitutional.
Once you see human beings as human beings who hurt, who love, who fall in love, who want to learn and explore and participate in the full range of human activity, I think it does influence the way you look at the rest of the world.
A third danger is timidity. Moral courage is a rarer commodity than bravery in battle or great intelligence. For the fortunate amongst us, the fourth danger, my friends, is comfort. The temptation to follow the easy and familiar path of personal ambition and financial success.
One of the hardest things to do as the legal profession has become a legal business is to remember why we became lawyers. And Margie is the example of the person who has never forgot.
Nelson Mandela woke up to freedom this morning in the spectacular surroundings of Bishop's Court, Archbishop Desmond Tutu's official residence on the slopes of Table Mountain.
Each time a man stands up for an ideal, or acts to improve the lot of others, or strikes out against injustice, he sends forth a tiny ripple of hope. Those ripples build a current which can sweep down the mightiest walls of oppression and resistance.
Every one of us just has to do a little something. What you cannot do if you want to change a system is do nothing.